Greetings, in this video we will be upgrading Sony HD-G700 firmware. So grab an USB drive and stick around if you want to learn how to do it. If you prefer a text version, visit turntool.tv for an article. Link is in the description below. First of all, we have to check what version soundbar does have. Go and turn on the soundbar, make sure that's connected to the subwoofer. There should be a green light on the subwoofer. A different software version is displayed depending on whether subwoofer is connected or not. Grab the remote and press an order. Menu, a down arrow, and then select system, and then press the enter button on the remote control. Press down arrow continuously to select version, and then press enter button. Here you will find the soundbar firmware version information. Please write it down and go back to your PC. For some particular reason, each Sony region has a different firmware version number. I contacted Sony support and I quote that the software version will depend on the region you are located purchased the soundbar. That means that it is best to download from your local Sony website. So type Sony, your country name, in the Google search to find the local site. For example, Sony UK, Sony Lithuania, Sony Germany, etc. Next, go to your selected Sony page to find the firmware. I'll be using the Sony US website as an example because it's in English, but I have downloaded my firmware from the Lithuanian website. Find the Sony HD-G700 page, click support, and then downloads. There you will find the latest firmware. Now it's time to use the notes you took previously. Compare them if you still need to upgrade, and then let's continue. Click on its firmware link. On the new page, you'll see the download button. Save the firmware file on the folder you'll find later. If you're downloading with Chrome, you might get a security warning. Now we will need to prepare our flash drive. We will need to format it to FAT32, and I'll show you how to do it. A big warning. Formatting will delete all the files, so make sure you don't have anything important in there. So we open the file explorer and find your USB drive. Before formatting, compare the size of the disk and to make sure you have the correct USB drive. And then simply right-click and select format. In the new window that will open, select the file system as FAT32. Make sure quick format is checked and click start. It will be done in a few seconds. Now let's find the firmware file. It will be a zip archive, so extract it. Inside you'll find a bin file. Copy or move that file to your USB drive. And now you're ready to upgrade the firmware. Insert the USB drive with the new firmware into the back of the soundbar. Power on the soundbar as usual, make sure the subwoofer is connected, the green light thing, refer to the manual if it's not, press the menu button and then the down arrow on the remote control until you hit update. And select it by pressing the enter button. Next, start will appear. By pressing the enter button, the update process will begin and the 0% will appear on display. Very important, do not turn off the device and leave it to finish the process. It will take around from 5 to 10 minutes to complete. So grab a cup of tea or something. When it's finished, the done will be displayed on the screen. The soundbar will restart automatically. Be sure to check that the firmware version was updated to the latest version by referring to the previous steps. Congratulations, you did it! If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments. Also check my channel for other videos you might like and check the description on how you can support me. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button and consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.